So there are some other similarities, like you can, which you can see which are in close relation to that as well. So basically, as Ryan described, the city of Los Angeles, as you can see here, this is another picture. So this is the picture of like depiction of hell in Paradise Lost by Milton. So at the first glance, you can see like there is not much difference between two. Both of them look like very depressing and very like violent, and like this is like it has been described like a sea of flames, and also there is like destruction and chaos that is going on. So we can say that the setting of the entire film takes place in like this sulfurous dark furnace, which is like Milton's hell. So like there's a close comparison between the setting of Paradise Lost and the setting of Blade Runner. Also, in the scene, in the end of the scene, we can see that Batty has a dove in his hand, and like the replicants have a lifespan of around four years. So he's about to die in the end of the film, and he has a dove in his hand, and he like releases the dove. So as we can see in this scene. So this is basically, he has the dove in his hand and he's about to die, and he releases the dove. So this is a very biblical illusion, and you can see that the clouds like are scattering out. So we can see that this is like the first glance of light that we can see in the film. Like the entire film is really dark, and this is the first like light that we can see, which is very similar to like Milton invoking the Holy Spirit. So basically, Milton asks the Holy Spirit like to shed some light, and this is also like giving a new hope, giving a new light. So this is like a very close comparison, and I think that the director like basically based this scene on Paradise Lost. So let's move on to certain characters that bear similarity to the characters in Paradise Lost. So the first one that we are going about is the character of Roy Batty, who is the leader of the replicants. So like a quick profile of him, he's like the leader of the Renegade Nexus 6 replicants, and he's portrayed as the film's main antagonist. So he was activated in January 8, 2016, which in accordance to the film, in the film, he's basically 3 years and 10 months old, so he does not have long to live because they live only for 4 years. So he's also like more intelligent, and he's a highly skilled combatant with superhuman strength. And also throughout the film, like we can see that he's trying to develop emotions. He's trying to learn the meaning of life, and like in the end, we see that it's a futile quest that he goes on to seek more about life. So basically, we can see that there are a lot of similarities that are present between Satan of Paradise Lost and Batty, which can be seen in Blade Runner. So basically, the first one is both of them are like leaders. So Satan is the leader of the rebel angels, as shown in Paradise Lost, and Batty is the leader of like the rebel replicants who like mutinied against in the off-world colonies. Also, we can see that both of them like seek to achieve a status which makes them like equal to their creators. So basically, Roy Batty, this is Tyrell, who is basically the creator of all the androids. So basically, God is like the creator of Satan. So both of them like try to achieve a status which is equal to their own creators. And also we can see that in the film, after they return to Earth, in order to search his maker, Roy sets like on a course of destruction. So he like destroys everything that is present in his path, and he kills like human beings without any remorse. Similarly, we can see that like Satan turns his eyes to Earth, and he decides to like defeat God by like corrupting his unique creation, which is humans. So basically, we can see that this is like a correlation that is kind of existing between the two. Like Satan wants to corrupt humanity, and Roy Batty tries to like destroy humans in his quest to search his maker. Also, so in this film, like after watching this film, a very important question raised in my mind: like, who is the real hero of the film? So as in Paradise Lost, Satan has, like Milton portrays Satan as a very heroic character in the first few books. So he gives like heroic speeches, he comes out as a very valiant warrior, a fighter, he has a lot of confidence. Of course, he like degrades both physically and mentally as the book progresses. But in the end, we see that he has been banished to hell. So, and still he builds up his confidence and tries to fight. So basically, at the end of the book, we try and sympathize with him. And it's a very ambiguous question, but it can be raised that whether Satan was the real hero in Paradise Lost. Similarly, in the film, we can see that Batty basically, his only reason to come back to Earth is to gain emotions, to learn more about life. And so that's his main goal. And of course, he has been shown like the villain, like he has been displayed like very violent, very dark, and like a typical villain. But in the end, we see that in the last scene, it's like he's trying to chase Deckard and trying to kill him. But this is very big plot twist that we see, that Deckard is like hanging from a ledge, and Patty could have killed him easily. But instead, he decides to save his life. And after that, he like goes on to like tell a very big monologue in which he says that his memories will be lost like tears in rain. So this is like the transformation of Patty into a good character, and we see that he has understood the true meaning of life, and he has understood like what it means to be good. So in the end, after he dies, we like start sympathizing with him, and like it can be asked, this the same question can be raised in this case, that whether Patty was a real hero in the film, just like the question which is raised in Paradise Lost, as like whether Satan was a real hero.